Hello dear learners, I welcome you all to the today's video lecture on repeatedly asked questions, that is board exam questions on the chapter sedative and hypnotics. So as you all know, we are dealing with the series of CNS depressant drugs. We have started with the tranquilizers. Tranquilizers again turn into CNS depressants, same as that of sedative and hypnotics. So, sedative and hypnotics, to deal with first with the chapter, we are supposed to understand the repeatedly asked questions in the board exam so that you will come to know the important points on which you are supposed to stress on. So, coming towards the questions, you can see in the first question, very first question is a general question like classify sedative and hypnotics. So, till now, whatever the chapters we have covered, we have seen that this question is really very common, classification. So, classification of sedative hypnotics is really very important from the exam point of view, which comes for generally for 2 marks, or it may come separately for 3 marks. And along with that, one adjoint question is also there that gives the structure of phenobarbitone. So, phenobarbitone, it's again a barbituric acid derivative which we are going to study under the classification of sedative hypnotics. So, the phenobarbitone structure they have asked along with the classification. So, the structure carries 1 mark and the total marks comprise 3. Second question, if you will see, definition of sedative and hypnotics. So, definition and classification again is very important from the exam point of view, which was not the case with tranquilizers. Tranquilizers, the more stress is given upon the drugs, its structures, etc. But here, definition and classification, many a times they have asked in the exam. Now, again, along with the definition, see, they have asked the classification. So, definition along with example will carry 1 mark, and classify sedative hypnotics with example will carry 2 marks, so the total marks 3 marks. Next question, question number 3, as you can see, they have asked again the question about the phenobarbitone, but here not only the structure, they have asked chemical name also of phenobarbitone. So each point carries 1 mark, structure carries 1 mark and chemical name carries 1 mark. So the total mark comprises 2. Then question 4, if you will proceed, they are asking a question on the heterocycle present. So, the question is, name a sedative hypnotic containing piperidine ring in its structure. So, sedative hypnotic which contains piperidine ring in it is nothing but, this phenobarbitone is nothing but barbituric acid derivative. So, this is the next drug which contains piperidine ring in its structure. So, what it is, we will see in detail in the video of respective drug. Then, give its structure and chemical name. So, along with the name, they are also asking the structure and chemical name. So, each point will carry 1 mark. Structure and chemical name will carry 1 mark. And it can carry 3 marks also if the weightage is given to the common name also. Then question number 5, write the structure and name of drug possessing following moiety. Now again here comes the phenobarbitone. So phenobarbitone, you can see the difference, how many types, by how many ways they have asked. They have asked straightforward question about the structure of phenobarbitone, and in this question they are asking draw the structure of drug possessing barbituric acid. So this is the moiety which phenobarbitone contains. So, the structure is same, answer is same. You are supposed to draw the structure of phenobarbitone only. But, it is asked in different way. So, the drawing the structure carries 1 mark. Coming towards the next question, what are barbiturates? Now, here you are supposed to describe barbiturates. That means, barbiturates, not only the definition, not only the what are the parts, but you are supposed to explain diagrammatically that the fusion units of barbiturates, what are they and how the barbituric acid is formed, and then the derivatives of the barbituric acid. This, what are barbiturates, carry 1 mark. Then classification, again, carries 2 marks and draw the structure of phenobarbital. So again the structure is asked, but it is now along with the different questions such as what are barbiturates and classify them. So this question carries 4 marks in total. Then question number 7, again see phenobarbital. As you can see the phenobarbital question, what you have asked? Properties, uses, structure, official preparation, brand names. So each and every aspect about the phenobarbital is important. So the phenobarbital complete drug is important from the exam point of view, which carries 4 marks. Then again definition they have asked of that of sedative and hypnotic, and again the IUPAC they have asked of the phenobarbital again. So here only two drugs are important, drug containing piperidine ring, that is glutathione, and this phenobarbital. Then question number 9 is give the stability and storage conditions of paraldehyde. Now paraldehyde as that of like your hormones, the stability and storage condition is important, like your general anesthetics, in that case stability and storage is important. So from this sedative hypnotics, that is CNS depressant, paraldehyde is again really very important from the stability and storage conditions point of view, which is asked for 2 marks. And then last question is name the drug in following brand. What is the brand? The brand name is Gardenal. So Gardenal again it is phenobarbital. So see how much the phenobarbital is important. Here in exam they have asked a straightforward question in question number 7, that brand names of phenobarbital. And here again other way round, they have asked a brand, they have given the brand name and they are asking for the name of the drug. So the brand name they have asked is Gardenal, and you are supposed to write down the name of the drug, that is phenobarbital. So this question carries 1 mark, writing the name of the drug which exists under the following brand name. So to summarize the questions which we have seen just now, to recollect them, we have seen that definition and classification of sedative and hypnotics is really very important. Along with the structure, there are two structures which are important from the sedative and hypnotics. One is phenobarbital, which is a barbituric acid derivative, and other is glutathione, which contains piperidine ring in its structure and which is a non-barbituric acid derivative. So in exam, one may ask you non-barbituric acid derivative belonging to sedative hypnotic category, or they may ask you the drug which contains piperidine ring, or sedative hypnotic which contains piperidine ring, or they may ask you barbituric acid derivative, or they may straightforward ask you the structure of phenobarbital. And along with the structure of phenobarbital, the complete drug phenobarbital is important. That is, starting from the structure, IUPAC, properties, uses, official preparation, brand names, everything, every aspect of phenobarbital is important from exam point of view. Then, stability and storage of paraldehyde is important in sedative hypnotics, as that of it is important in say for example some vitamins, some antibiotics or some general anesthetics, the stability storage is important. So as far as sedative hypnotic is concerned, paraldehyde stability and storage is important. And again the question is on phenobarbital, but it is asked in different way. How they have asked? They have asked the brand name, sorry, they have asked the name of drug which exists under the brand Gardenal. So you are supposed to write the name of the drug. With this, we finish with the repeatedly asked questions of sedative hypnotics. Thank you.